friends, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss some RCC design questions. We'll move to first question. An RCC beam can have maximum tension reinforcement as option A 6% B into D, option B 2% BD, option C 3% BD, and option D 4% BD. Here B indicates breadth of the RCC beam section and capital D indicates depth of the RCC beam. Now in RCC beam section, the maximum tension reinforcement is 4% of breadth into depth. So option D is the correct answer. Similarly, in RCC column, the maximum tension reinforcement is 6% of the breadth into depth. Move to second question. Characteristic strength of concrete is measured at option A 14 days, option B 28 days, option C 91 days, and option D 7 days. As per IS 456-2000, the characteristic strength of concrete is measured at 28 days. Option B is the correct answer. Next question. The maximum depth of neutral axis for a beam with Fe 415 bars in limit state method of design is option A 0.46D, option B 0.48D, option C 0.50D, and option D 0.53D. Here we have Fe value as 415, so the neutral axis depth of neutral axis is 0.48. Here the table Fy value with respect to maximum neutral axis depth. Here for 250 neutral axis depth is 0.53, and 415 it is 0.48, and for Fe 500 the value is 0.46. Here option B is the correct answer. Next question. IS has specified the full strength of concrete after option D 28 days. Next question. Permissible compressive strength of M20 concrete grade is option A 100 kg per centimeter square, option B 150 kg per centimeter square, option C 200 kg per centimeter square, and option D 250 kg per centimeter square. Here in M20 grade concrete, M indicates mix and 20 indicates compressive strength of concrete in Newton per mm square. The permissible compressive strength of concrete grade is 20 Newton per mm square. It is nothing but 200 kg per centimeter square. So option C is the correct answer. Next question. Ordinary concrete is not used for concrete grade. Option A M10, option B M15, option C M25, and option D M40. As per IS 456-2000, we have one table for the grade of concrete. Here for ordinary concrete, the strength are M20, M10 to M20, and for standard grade it is M25 to M55, and high strength concrete is M60 to M80. So here ordinary grade is M10 to M20. So option D is the correct answer, because M40 is not an ordinary concrete. Next question. Permissible compressive strength of M20 concrete grade is, it is the same question we have discussed before, it is option D 20 kg per centimeter square. Next question. If a beam fails in bond, then its bond strength can be increased most economically by option A increasing the depth of beam, option B using thinner bars but more in number, option C using thicker bars but less in number, and option D none of the above. Here option B is the correct answer, using thinner bars but more in number. By using more number of thinner bars, the required development length gets reduced and thus it improves the bond strength. So option B is the correct answer. Next question. According to IS 456-2000, the maximum reinforcement in column is, option C is the correct answer, 6%. Next question. The modular ratio M is given by, here option C is the correct answer. M is given by 280 divided by 3 sigma CBC. Next question. The load factors for live load and dead load are, Here option A 1.8 and 2.2, option B 2.2 and 1.5, option C 1.8 and 1.8, and option D 2.2 and 2.2. Here the load factor is considered greater than 2 for both live load and dead load when design is based on failure loads. So here option D is the correct answer, because 2.2 and 2.2 for both live load and dead load, it is greater than 2. Next question, the partial safety factor for concrete is, the partial safety factor for concrete is 1.5. option B is the correct answer. Similarly, the partial safety factor for steel is 1.15. Next question, the minimum grade of reinforcement concrete in sea water as per IS 456-2000 is, option A M15, option B M20, option C M30, and option D M40. As per IS 456-2000, the concrete in seawater or exposed directly along the sea coastal cost shall be at least M20 grade in the case of plain concrete and M30 in case of reinforced concrete. So here in question, the minimum grade for grade of reinforced concrete in C is asked. So option D, option C is the correct answer, M30. Next question, the value of ultimate creep coefficient for concrete. Option A increases with age of loading, decreases with age of loading, remains constant, and option D is taken as 0.003. Here the value of ultimate creep coefficient for concrete decreases with age of loading. Option B is the correct answer. Next question, partial safety factor for concrete and steel respectively may be taken as. Here option A is correct answer, because partial safety factor for steel is 1.5 and for concrete is 1.15. Next question, the characteristic strength of concrete is defined as, that strength below which not more than fill in the blanks of the rest result are expected to fall. Here option A 10%, B 5%, C 15%, and D 20%. Here option B is the correct answer, 5%. Next question, additional cover thickness in reinforcement cement concrete members totally immersed in sea water. Here option A is 25 mm, B 30 mm, option C 35 mm, and option D 40 mm. Here the correct answer is option D, 40 mm. Next question, the characteristic strength of concrete in the actual structure is given as. Here option A FCK, option B 0.85 FCK, option C 0.67 FCK, and option D 0.447 FCK. Here the maximum characteristic strength to be used in actual structure is restricted in 0.67 FCK. So option C is the correct answer. Next question, in limit state of collapse against flexure, the maximum strain in tension reinforcement at failure shall not be less than. Option D is the correct answer. Next question, according to IS 456-2000, the maximum depth of stress block for balanced section of beam of effective depth D using steel with FI 250 is given by. Here we already have seen this question, similar question. Here FI 250 is given. For FI 250, option B is the correct answer, 0.53D. If it is FI 415, 0.48D, and if it is FI 500, 0.43D. So here option B is the correct answer. Next question, the characteristic strength of concrete is defined as, that compressive strength below which not more than. Here option 2, option A 2% of result fall, option B 10% of result fall, and option C 5% of result fall, option D none of these. Here option C is the correct answer, 5% of results fall. Next question, the modulus of elasticity of concrete in Newton per mm square can be assumed as follows, where FCK is the characteristic strength cube compressive strength of concrete in Newton per mm square. Here option B is the correct answer. For concrete, the modulus of elasticity is 5000 root of FCK. Next question. The horizontal distance between parallel main reinforcement in RC slab shall not be more than. Here option A, 4 times effective depth of slab, 5 times effective depth of slab, option C, 3 times effective depth of slab, and option D, 2 times effective depth of slab. Here, the horizontal distance between parallel main reinforcement bar shall not be more than 3 times the effective depth of solid slab or 300 mm, whichever is smaller. So here option C is the correct answer, 3 times effective depth of slab. Next question. Critical section for calculating bending moment for a spread concrete footing of effective depth D is given by the plane at. Here option C is the correct answer, column face. Next question. If L is the effective length of column and B is the least lateral dimension, then the column will be treated as short column if the ratio of length by breadth is equal to or less than. Here option B is the correct answer, 12. Next question. Compressive strength, a compression member is termed as column or strut if the ratio of its effective length to the least lateral dimension is more than. Option A, 3, option B, 5, option C, 1, and option D, 2. Here the correct answer is A, 3 is the correct answer. Next question. If the modular ratio is M, stress ratio in steel and concrete is R, then the critical neutral axis constant K is given by. Here option B is the correct answer, M divided by M plus R. Next question. As per IS 456, splitting tensile strength of concrete may be estimated from compressive strength as. Here option B is correct answer, split tensile strength is equal to 0.7 into root of FCK. Next question. In a singly reinforced beam, if the permissible stress in concrete reaches earlier than the permissible strength in steel, the beam section is called. Option A, under reinforced section, option B, over reinforced section, option C, balanced section, and option D, economic section. Here if the permissible strength in steel reaches earlier than permissible strength in concrete, it is called under reinforced section. Here in this question, the permissible strength in concrete reaches earlier than the permissible strength in steel, so it is over reinforced section. If both are at the same time, it is called balanced section. So here option B is the correct answer. Next question. If the area of tension reinforcement provided is less than that required for a balanced section, then the RCC beam section is called. Here it is clearly mentioned the area of tension reinforcement is less than required, so it will be under reinforced section. Option C is the correct answer. Next question.